Hi, my name is Sharon. Today I will be reviewing a 12-inch revolving annealing pan with pumice stone for Cooks & Gold.
This is the annealing pan without the pumice stone in. It's very large. Nice and deep. It runs on ball bearings, so it has a nice rotation there, very easy. Move it, and it runs for quite some time. Right, and then this one at the top is 12 inches, but you've got underneath, it doesn't come with any instructions, so I'm not sure about this, but I am presuming that this one can be used also as a, annealing pan for smaller items. I've measured this is 7 inches, so you've got a 2-in-1 here. You've got the 12 inch and then you have the smaller one that's 7 inches, which is wonderful because you can put the pumice in either one and use the smaller one or the larger one. I like this small one for smaller jobs. Because you can quite easily use all of this area to put your pick and put your solder, and so they're easy to hand. But yeah, 2-in-1, 7-inch and 12-inch. Nice. So I'm going to go and put the pumice stone into the larger one now and let you see what that's like. So this is the annealing pan with the pumice stone in. It's a really nice weight when the pumice stone is in, and you can revolve it really nicely, and it carries on for quite some time on its own, which is a bonus when you're soldering. The pan is absolutely wonderful for larger sheets of metal. They fit in there great, and say you can anneal these, revolving the pan to disperse the heat all the way around. The pumice stone will hold the heat and help with that as well. What I really like about pumice stone is the ability to be able to put the pieces in and keep them there so that they're held when you're soldering or something. You put the pumice stone around the piece, keep it in place so that it doesn't fall, it doesn't move, and so you can solder pieces onto that. I make prayer boxes like this, the cylinder, and this is brilliant for that because it keeps it still, it's not going to move. What happened to me recently was I had one of these on a block and I was soldering the seam and it fell off onto my leg and it burnt me, and it was a really bad burn. So had I have had this, this wouldn't have happened. Same here with this sort of piece. While it's being soldered, you push that in there, get the pumice all around it so that it's held and it's not going to move. Then you can revolve the piece, getting the heat all the way around, and it's held nicely so it's not going to fall over. That's what I really like about pumice stone. It keeps and it holds the piece. You can also use a block on the pumice stone so that it's like a normal revolving soldering platform. That way you can use it for both. The only downside I have found to pumice stone is that if you drop solder onto the pumice, chances are you're not going to find it again. It will fall all the way down to the bottom. So that is the only downside. I can't see any other downside to it. I love it. It has changed the way I solder. It's helped me a lot with
pieces that are odd shapes, and I think it's great. Nice size too. I hope you've enjoyed my review today. If you have, please like and subscribe. And if you would like to review products for Cooks and Gold, press the link below.